Leave a message and I'll get back to you.
Berkey, it's Pigtails Productions. Hey, I know you got a lot on your plate right now. I just wanted to talk to you about us maybe doing a weekly video series about the WSOP. You know, what it's like to win, what it's like to fail, blah, blah, blah. I know we don't know a lot about poker, but on the flip side, we really need the money. Talk soon, bud.
Mr. Matt Berkey, the fish that left Pittsburgh.
Is that a basketball reference?
Point is, a fish is some. I looked it up. A fish is someone who's right. Bad at poker.
Right.
Tell me about the World Series.
I mean, a better lead-in than that. What would you like to know?
Like, literally, what is it?
Bunch of poker tournaments that you go down to the Rio to play, and you lose every day except for one of the days you hopefully win, and that makes up for all the days you lose.
And that's fun?
That one day.
How do you stop yourself from just driving out of Nevada and off the nearest cliff instead?
I lie to myself a lot.
What is a bracelet?
A bracelet as it pertains to poker or as it pertains to like what we give little kids?
No, I'm not confused about what you give little kids.
Yeah, when, like at a bar mitzvah or something.
It is the trophy. Instead of the standard trophy that you put on your mantle, mm-hmm. It's a gold bracelet.
Do you have one?
A bracelet?
Yeah.
No.
I do, actually, from some cheap casino in Arizona.
Oh.
Not a real one.
Not one that people care about?
No.
Why do this if you don't know if you're going to get anything out of it?
That's life's biggest question.
You know, a lot of people have stable jobs and salaries and guaranteed income.
But they don't know what they're going to do with their life.
Well, they seem to have things figured out more than some of the poker players I know.
That's very true.
Every tournament has this thing called a dinner break.
Yeah.
What's that?
What's a dinner break?
Yeah.
It's a pause in the action for us to strap on a feed bag and take care of ourselves.
So it's exactly what it sounds like.
Sure.
It's not code for something else.
No. No.
Do you think maybe you're just not invited to the cool dinner break?
Totally possible.
Here it is, a groove slightly transformed. Just a bit of a break from the norm. Just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance? Give me a soft, subtle mix. And if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And think of the summers of the past. Adjust the bass and let the alpine blast. Pop in my CD and let me run a rhyme. And put your car on cruise and lay back, cause it's summertime.
It sinks in with like the first time you walk in the Rio. All your preparation, all of your everything that it's right now. And it's like, man, there is a lot of people here.
I think my first series was 2006 and I missed one maybe in between. So this is probably 12.
Number 9.
This will be number 3.
My buy-ins add up to like 120K or so.
35,000 in WSOP events. That's not counting if I have to re-enter. So could be like 50.
We've put in $60,000 towards the series.
I've had 4 summers where I've made 6 figures. My best one being 2013 where I grossed 550-ish.
Last summer, it's like 275-ish in cashes.
Anytime you leave the series in the black, you won.
The summer right before that, 2012, I bricked all but I think 2 events. I think I got 19th in like a 6 max for like 6K.
I went 0 for 24 my very first summer.
If you just like play and bust 3 tournaments, you're not feeling it. That 4th tournament, like you're very likely to not win.
Oh, I definitely want the sweat. More than anything else, like I want to hear about the deep runs. Like there's a certain element about being able to sweat other people's action even if you don't have a piece.
My biggest rule of swapping with people in tournaments is that I only swap with people that I think are better than me.
Usually you just say, like, oh, I'm peaced out or like something like that. Like, you kind of just lie.
There's always been these points where it's like somebody's on a heater or whatever, you got to be like, oh, that's one of my close friends.
You root for them and like you see their lines and like you see like the updates of like who had like the craziest lines.
For someone like Chin, it's just like Christmas.
It's so much fun. Like, for me, it's just like so much fun because I'm friendly with so many people in the community, and like when they make a final table, like I go there just to show support and like drink.
I definitely feel prepared. I feel like I'm better now than I've ever been.
Doing the MTT Academy was like probably more enlightening for me than a lot of the students.
I feel like I see the spots better than I've ever have. I feel like I'm just not afraid to pull triggers. I feel really good. I don't know, I haven't felt better, so.
I have the schedule planned out that I'll be playing literally every day.
I'm gonna play like 45 out of the next 50.
So it's nice to kind of just like dig your heels in and just know that every day for the next month and a half or two, you have a huge opportunity, but like you're also just gonna fail a lot. The kind of beauty of shootouts is it's a winner-take-all format each day until you get to the final day, in which case then it becomes just a regular tournament. But the winner-take-all format is nice because you're just incentivized to win all the chips, which is great for me. I play a lot of hands. I play cash for a living, so like this is directly correlated. Just didn't go my way. I made a pretty tight fold with ace-king versus two shoves really, really early. And I would have won a sort of flip. They had pocket eights, pocket queens, and I would have made trip kings, but whatever. I made the correct play, gotta just live with the results. You know, yada, yada, yada. It was unavoidable. Like, sometimes you just, we talked about this a little bit at the MTT Academy, and I think it's a good perspective to have. Like, there's just a lot of times in tournament play that through your card distribution, you can't win, right? Because it's a timed event and a certain number of mistakes have to take place at opportune times in order for somebody to profit. And those mistakes may be taking place where I just don't have hands that I could do anything about it with, or like I make what is by the book a correct fold with ace king, but because I didn't gamble there, I'm just not gonna be dealt the distribution there forward to win. I think it was like largely out of my hands. I think I could have made a bad play and called off with ace-king and probably won my table. I had a drunk guy to my right who had 3x starting stack, and I just felt like I was probably in a good spot to play it a little tight to the vest. He busted me. Yeah, and I think like when I'm in a better frame of mind, you get excited by that because it's like, oh my God, poker is alive and well. Like, over the long run, these guys don't stand a chance and I'm here to pick up the pieces. But it's also just like, it's hard not to over expect things and just think like, oh, I have a soft shootout table, I should win this at a high percentage. Well, high percentage is like 25%, and it's like, you know, I didn't today and I'm sour.
So you don't know if you're gonna win money, but you think that poker is a game of skill?
Yeah, I mean, tournament poker is brutal. Like, within your lifetime you will very likely not actualize your expected value. So
that's what EV means.
Yeah, expected value. Yeah, we got it.
So you're playing tournaments all day.
Yep.
Like you said, you bust at 2:30 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Well out of the money.
Not even close.
Sun's blazing. It's hot.
Yep.
Talk about those summer nights.
It's not exciting.
But isn't it?
No, it's not exciting at all.
Let's pretend the World Series doesn't even exist.
Sure.
And you have this like extra $100,000 that you just now have kind of to play with. What charity would you give it to?
If I didn't have anything in mind, I would just give it to Reg because they do a good job of making sure.
So keep it within the poker world.
Yeah, I mean, they're not solely poker based, but
mostly white.
Yeah, kind of white.
Mostly white men.
No, I mean, I'm just trying to think of which Bulldog charity I would give it to. I just don't know.
A charity exclusive to Bulldogs?
Yeah.
Like research?
No. Rescue.
If you win over $1 million this summer, who are you going to shut out of your life first?
I don't know if I'd shut them out because I wouldn't want them to not see me have all this money.
Yeah. You'd hold it over them?
Yeah, like right in front of them, really.
Big fish, small pond.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Speaking of being a fish.
Yes.
Berkeley, that's where I stay.